Hit the elevator.
Oh, hi, Josh.
So, have you ever played Final Fantasy?
What?
Oh, but like, it's one of the most successful RPG games of all time.
What, you mean like Earthbound?
Yeah, it's got a... Yeah.
Will that happen?
Welcome back, people. Earthbound, the game that is a modern RPG, and which is a sequel to another game, which we didn't know for 20 years over in the Western. Also, you probably have heard of it. Yes, we're going to talk about Earthbound. I mean, since it's like the third time you've probably heard this word, so let's get right into it. Oh, and beware, spoilers. Let's go! The game starts off with a naming screen, and the music is actually good. Setting up the mood really good there. I like it. Ness wakes up because of a meteor falling nearby. I mean, if I heard that sound, I'd probably be pretty much shocked out of bed. So as a brave boy, we inspect the meteorite, and it's blocked. Well, at least we tried. So I guess it's back to sleep!
Oh, what now?
Oh look, it's Pokey! Anyway, Pokey needs our help in yada yada yada. Ooh, a bug! No, no, not like a bug in the way that it's a glitch or anything. No, it's literally an insect, fly, or something. And whatever this thing is, it's dead now. Okay, let us start our adventure. Adventure! Yeah! Now, you might be asking yourself, David, why are you doing this? I think you mean, how good is this game? Yeah, let's talk about that. Now, let's start with the story. So you have to find 8 sanctuary locations to hear a special part of a song called 8 Melodies. That's pretty much it. Now, the game shines in its gameplay, its characters, its music, and its humor. I mean, of course, it's graphics. Oh, look, a dog! It's not a friendly one. Oh, look at this thing rolling now. This is your honor meter. This is the game's biggest lifesaver of making combat interesting in this game. As you take damage, the honor meter will roll down, and this means that you can easily recover from any mortal hits. You can also use several PSI attacks in this game, which is pretty much this game's magic attacks. Now let's really start the adventure. Wait, are those punks? My sworn enemy has returned. And they're dead. This guy will go down easy. Oh look, it's a tank. Well, damn. We beat a giant ant and we got the first melody. Good job, us. Then we stomp some cultists. Wait, whoa. What did I just say?
Then we stomp some cultists.
There's a cult in this game? That's 10 out of 10, perfect. Then more stuff happened and oh, what is this? Spooky ghost town. Spooky. Oh, these guys. We all know them. Oh, another boss. It's whatever this is. Okay, who threw puke in my game? So now we're stuck in a desert. Yay, traffic. And now we're in the big city. And we lost a party member. And now we're on drugs. Oh look, Porky's back. And we got our first party member. So first we have Paola. Now she's the PSI type here. And she can also pray to whatever religion she is committed to. Then we have Jeffrey, which is the party's nerd, and biggest game-breaking thing in this game. I mean, his multi-bottle rockets can take any boss, yes, boss down in one go. That's a little bit OP. And then there's Pooh.
I am the great mighty...
No, not that kind of Pooh. Pooh is the offensive PSI in this game, and he doesn't like Western food, so don't bother feeding him chips or pizza or anything else useful to your party. Anyway, let's move on. We later on sail on this boat and we get attacked by a Kraken. Now, I have a serious question to the developers here. The Kraken, isn't it supposed to be a giant octopus thing or something? Okay, because this looks much more like a sea serpent. What? Then we meet a giant dungeon man. A man who literally turned himself into a giant dungeon. Now that is true dedication there. It's true dedication. Now we're in a village where everyone is shy. Oh, is there a book that can cure shyness? Man, some of my friends really need that. Oh, some people disappeared? Let's check Winters. Oh, you see that enemy there? Yeah, this enemy can die in hell. Why? Well, this enemy holds Poopy's only weapon. We don't really count yo-yos, okay? They suck. And that weapon has only one out of 128. One out of 128 chance to drop. Do you know how rare that is? That is me trying to grind hours to get this sword, while freaking Chuka Conry can only get it after 5 freaking battles. We beat the Starman Deluxe, beat the next area, get the book, and we're small. And we move with the snails. Well then, after more adventuring, Ness falls asleep and wakes up in Magican, your inner conscience. Well, I mean, Ness's inner conscience. After beating your worst nightmare, you wake up not in an hospital, because friends, why would you bring a person who falls unconscious in front of you to a hospital? I mean, that would be way too nice, right? We travel to the past and we find Gygas, but oh look at this, Porky was under Gygas's control. Oh no. At least his battle theme is pretty cool. And what the fuck? So that was Earthbound. The music is incredible in this game, the characters are really rememberable, and the humor is kind of goofy, with some little dark humor in there. Now I do have one con with the game, and that has to be how the story works. Now the story is actually quite interesting, but it's the way that you have to go to the next area and all that. The game works that it's kind of explorative, but it also has this straight line, so you don't really know where to go, but you don't really know, but you do not really know where you are either. It's kind of hard to say, but if you don't have a walkthrough by yourself, it's gonna be quite hard to follow the story unless you talk to everybody and use the hint shops, but come on, you have to pay for them. It's easier to just use a walkthrough. And that's all I have to say about Earthbound. It's a really cool game, and there's a lot to it, and a lot of secrets and how the game works and all that. But I just wish there was like a game that had much more darkness to the world. Wait.
Jimmy and the Pulsating Mass? Guess I'll have to play it for next time.
Thank you guys for watching. I would like to say I loved making this video. This was probably one of the funniest videos I've made. Not only what I think, but it was really enjoyable to make. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see more content like this. Share it to your friends. It would really help me out. And like the video, of course, if you enjoyed it. And please give me feedback, since I am working a lot on making my channel something unique. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!